So now what we're interested in asking the question, given an image like this, how would we transform it to image like this? Again, here I'm basically showing a little bit of scaling in one direction only. Let's start off by basically finding two points on my original image F. This is my original image F, and I'm trying to get my output image G. Here I basically have two points that I've kind of marked. Of course, what we're now interested in is seeing where these two points would be on this image. Where would they transform to? So call this one P1, and we'll call this image or point here P2. This P1 and P2 have now moved to different points here. So of course, this is now all these two points. And just for sake of clarity, we will call this P2 prime, and then we will call this P1 prime. So in essence, now what we have to figure out is how to transform the point P to P prime. So in essence, what we need now is a simple function that takes any point P, of course, in this case, they would have values of X and Y, to generate a new point P prime. In this case, we want to find one function T, which has a set of parameters that actually applies this thing entirely to the whole image. So in this case, I'm basically talking about one function that directly applies to each and every pixel. This basically means that this would be a global warp. The same parametric function would be applied to the entire image. So in essence, what we're talking about is a global function that given a P, we would always get a P prime. And just to reiterate, what basically I'm talking about is I want to come up with a few set of simple parameters. So by now you've noticed that I like to convert everything to matrices because that's a great representation for us to be playing around with. And of course, this is true here. What we really want to do is find a matrix that encodes all of the transformation or the parameters, and then when applied to point P, and again, remember, this would be just simple X and Y to generate a new X and Y. Basically, this is the simple two-dimensional transformation we're looking at. Given a matrix M that has certain sets of parameters, when applied to point X and Y, anywhere in this F function, which is my first one, I would get an output G, which would have all X primes and Y primes. So by just looking at this, you may note that this M should be a 2x2 matrix. And now let's try to figure out what would be in this 2x2 matrix.